Today I'm doing a tutorial on this little epoxy coated soothing tray. This one is beach themed, and I did the beach design and then I did the epoxy over it and put two little handles on it. It's just a small little tray. It could fit a couple of cups, or you can do a little doily with some cheese on it and a little cheese knife. And that's perfect for that. It's a cute little gift and it's quick and easy. So I start off with a bamboo tray. This is actually a bamboo cutting board, and it came with a little hook right here that I just unscrewed off, and now it's just flat. And I bought these little handles, and I'm going to do these in silver because this is going to be marble, black and white marble. I'm not going to do the beach, and I think that the little silver handles, they have this little red thing on it, but I'm taking that out because I don't like the leaves. And I think I might go ahead and do a little bit of marble here for my handles to match my cutting board. The marble look is going to be black and white with a little bit of white crystal in certain little areas. I'm just going to use a black apple barrel acrylic paint and white apple barrel. Right now I mixed up my epoxy, and this is really not hard to do at all. My epoxy is mixed up, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a coat of epoxy over the top of it. Make sure that you protect your workspace with either waxed paper or parchment paper. Those both work well. Let me get my the wax paper and the parchment paper work really good to keep stuff off of your surface. If you have silicone mats, I have some little silicone mats that I use whenever I do flat surfaces also, but I don't have one right now that I'm using. I'm just went ahead and put. You can also, if you wanted to drip down and do the sides, you can put it, set it on upside down, some of these little cups like this, and make yourself four or six of them, and then set it on there, and it'll drip down the sides. I don't worry about that, because I finish off my sides, I just sand it, and then stain it. That's what I do. So I'm going to use this little silicone brush to spread some epoxy on my surface right here. This is really all the tools you need right now is you need epoxy, and you need your paint, and a little brush to rub it on with, and a heat gun, because you are going to blow some heat onto it. This is a simple project, but it really turns out cute. If you want to do, especially now, we're coming on a time of gift giving, and some people, if you have this stuff on hand, if you're a tumbler maker or jewelry maker and you already have epoxy. Now I see my fingers moving a little, so I'm just going to put a little bit of this. You can get anything, a towel or some shelf liner, just to keep your cup from moving. I mean, just to keep your board from moving, put something down, because the wax paper and the parchment paper are a little bit, well, this one's going to be too big, I don't want to do it all over my if you have like a shelf liner, you can put some under, and that'll keep it from moving. I can find a piece of shelf liner. Just put something on there. I'm going to see if I can get this to work well. Just to keep it, to give it some tension so I can use it. You don't want to keep it in there. Just do it when you are putting your paint on, I mean your epoxy on. Because you are going to have this on a flat surface once you are on a level surface. So a good thing to do is just get a little level wherever you're going to lay it with put the wax paper under, and then check your table or wherever you have it and make sure that your surface is level, because if it's dripping, if it moves over, if it's slanted, it's going to move over and it's going to drip off to the side. Okay, so I got my epoxy on there and I did 20 mls in two different little cups for my colors. My colors are just black and white. And then I am going to do a, I am going to do another, just some crystal, these crystal little things in there in one of the little areas. I might do it on the side, that way I can have a flat surface for whatever I'm going to serve. And like it. So I'm just going to mix a little bit of white in there. You don't want to mix a lot because the white, it causes it to be gummy. It causes the epoxy to be gummy. You're just going to pour it on. This is more like a pour on. Then I'm going to do the black first. A lot of times I'll just mix one color at a time since it does start to set really quick. But you can mix both colors. And, you look at your paint and you feel like if it's too light and you want a darker black, you can add a little bit more black paint. I don't know why this one's dripping like that, but I don't like that. Anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and start. Just all you do is a design. You know, it's going to be marble, so you're just going to get it on there. You get it on first and then you kind of shape your design. You want more black on here than white. Like, it just depends on what color you want. You can even add a different color. You can do pink or purple, whatever color, or blues look good with marble. It doesn't have to be black, but this customer wants a black marble. Right now all I'm focused on is getting my epoxy painted epoxy onto the marble. And it's not gonna look good at the beginning, but once you're done with it, it looks good. So now I've got this going. I'm just gonna do little lines through here. Just to get it moving. You can also use your silicone brush to get more coverage of an area. The black is kind of what I want as a base. You can also, if you don't want to use black epoxy, acrylic and epoxy, you can spray paint it all black and then come over with the white and other colors. So I've got the black on. Now you are going to have your handles like right here and right here. And it's okay if you have epoxy over, because you can drill through your epoxy once it's semi-set. You don't wait till it's completely hardened. But once it's set, you go and put your little handles on and just drill a little hole through there. I'm gonna do the white right now. And the white is just gonna go on a little line. You want your lines to be more of an angle. It's really a simple process. I'm going to mix a little more black now. I want my black in there. And you can mix any color you want. It doesn't have to be just two colors. I'm doing it in my custom colors. This is a simple, very simple process. just want the whole surface covered. The paint does start to make your epoxy get gummy, so you need to kind of work at a good pace. And then I am going to make them. And now that I've got, I'm going to add a little more white to some of my spots. I don't like to go crisscross this way, so if I get that on there, I'll just smudge it up and turn it green. And once you get all your color on there, one thing that I am going to do too is I'm going to mix a little bit of white. I'm going to mix a little bit of white acrylic paint with some alcohol, and it's 92% alcohol. What that's going to do is give it kind of like a smudgy look. Once I do my thing then. So just a little bit of alcohol, and just a little bit of white paint. I just dipped my popsicle stick in there. Little splashes. So this is like an alcohol ink. You just want to dip a little bit of it in the brush. This is just going to give it, like if you're doing a beach theme, this is good for the foam on it. Not a lot, just a certain amount. Right now it looks like spots. Once I get my heat gun on here, it's gonna look pretty good. So I use this heat gun right here, and I just got this on Amazon. I can link it if you need it, or send just comment and also send me a message and let me know what, if you want to know where to get this. Also, don't forget to follow this page. Subscribe to my channel so I can do more lives. All you're doing with this is moving your paint around. just change the shape of whatever you put on there if you don't want it to be too splotchy or too much of, like, rounded off or whatever. Just, you can use your heat gun to change your shape. And I have some spots right here where you can see my wood, so I'm going to cover it up with a little bit of liquid black. So that's all you do, guys. It's so simple and super cute once you get the handles on it. If you want to move color around, you can just pick it up and remove it. Just make sure you don't get it anymore. But that's all you do to this. And then once it dries, I will do a coat of epoxy over the top, and then I'll put my handles. I'm going to epoxy these little handles right now. Just put a little bit of black in there because this is where the little decoration was that I didn't like. You can sand it and prepare it a little better, but I'm just going to use this. It's just a simple little epoxy. And this is going to lay flat, and I'm going to let it dry. And the epoxy will dry, and we're fine. Just going to lay flat near a warm surface. And that's all I have to do. I'm just going to put some black in it. But if it's on the front I don't want, I'll just leave it off. And it's a lot of white. That's just too much. I will add a photo of, if you want to see this finished, I will probably have it on my Instagram and also on my Facebook page. It's Silly Design Studio on Facebook, and I will post a picture of it there. If you go to my Facebook page, follow my page, follow this, subscribe to this channel so I can do more live tutorials. They don't let you do lives unless you have 1,000 subscribers. Thank you very much for watching. Goodbye, everyone.